The beauty of nature. Yes, the beauty of nature. Another beautiful Thursday in the making. Happy Thursday. Beautiful morning already for me, and I'm loving every moment of it. I am loving the fact that I get to get up every day look at that nice drink falling on top of me, to meditate, do yoga, and come out and do my my little nice meditative yoga. So it's been a very interesting morning already, to where good morning. How are you? Oh, I can't complain. Have a great walk. Oh, so I'm just sort of here just thinking about all type of things and making sure I'm truly in line with myself. I begin to realize that this is not a run anymore. It is. Let me actually pick a route to go through. What I usually do every 3 hours, I began to chant and say like a little prayers. So truly, I'm actually just learning how to focus my mind. Let me see what route to go through today. Let's take this one. Truly focus my mind on being in the moment. So I repeat things repetitionally in my brain. So, and of course, I always start with thank you. So I'll say that for like an hour. While I'm moving my feet, I say that for like an hour. Then I switch again to their ohms and just different type of concentration to focus the mind, to really put the mind at ease. So now I've been starting, so I'm back to 2:22 getting up. So I'm actually just, I start my day with like 300 push-ups with the yoga. The thing about it is the 300 push-up probably take me about 3 hours, because I breathe heavy into the body, stretch the body out. Like, I literally take my time into breathing into the body, you know, slowly. That's how I wake up. So while I'm doing those push-ups, I'm drinking water until I feel a slight running nose. So, which is to me an indication that, okay, I'm hydrated enough. Then I begin to sit down and read. I'm actually reading a heavy, heavy, heavy book at the moment called The Utarian. I got to look at the spelling. But it is actually a heavy, heavy book. Wow, that is must be a good sign for me to see a chrome on this stop sign. Yes, it is a sign that I gotta figure out. This is not very often. Let me see if it will let me capture it. So I'm seeing this guy right here, and I know it's a sign. So the divine connection to the earth has become more of a thing for me now. I was reading an article yesterday. What's this guy's name? See, Michael something, who decided to run a marathon every day. And his story was so amazing to me that I said, okay, this is just an inspiration for me to continue to do what I'm doing. This is my next adventure to my new direction in life, believe it or not. This is like me filling out a job application, inquiring for the job. Good morning. So this is not a just ordinary run anymore. So it's pretty much just like a way to get into my inner self. And the whole thing behind consciousness and energy, compassion, love, have really overtaken me the last 10 years. Has just become so passionate. I've literally lived on the social media from the time it started, especially Facebook, and I don't see the addictive side that many people are talking about. I truly think it just depends on what you're looking for, truly, and where your mind actually lays. Because I'm always going to continue to say this, for somebody who has always questioned things a lot and who has also experienced colonialism and wanting to learn at an early stage, but without any tools, even though I was raised in England. So I think the social media to me isn't just a social media, because there's so much information that you can actually grasp in your own head, and you are actually allowed to choose. However, there's an exaggeration to everything in life. So however you want to look at it, it is up to the individual. But I do know one thing. Look at those beautiful places. The backslash that the social media received. Nobody ever said the same thing when different religions went to Africa and colonized and brutalized and miseducate and mistranslate religion. I've never seen so many people stand up for it like that, but at the same time, with the social media, I can actually Google my village that I used to live in, that I used to think is nothing, and I could actually see what's going on there. So to me, that's a very unique thing for me, that I can just type in my village and it'll come up. Because growing up, I was thinking my village is just a bunch of biscuits that nobody cares about. So my whole ideology was based on, yeah, I gotta go back to England, I'm English. But now just Googling those places and seeing the place that I used to live, it means a different meaning to me. It means, I call it collective consciousness, because now, in order for me to get over what I call anger from reading and finding out different things about your own self, the only way to get over anger is true love. And when you begin to love yourself and embrace your own traditional culture, you see everyone as one. Because I don't care what anyone says, you cannot use hate to solve the problem of hate. Absolutely impossible. So, and over the years, that's what I've learned through reading, running, and looking at the social media. And I think it allowed me to take a different route in this life to what many that I grew up you know, many that I grew up are doing. My friends, I'm really happy for them. They are busy being a good parent, husband. They did all these wonderful things. Nice job. You name it. They get to do all those things. But my journey was totally different. I love it when I see kids running. Oh, I love that. Hello. How are you? How are you doing? What's going on, sir? Have a great walk. Yeah, I love that. So, and I embrace what everyone has accomplished. You know, because like I said, a lot of my friends that I grew up with, just seeing them in all the beautiful things that they've accomplished, I've always support them. But for my journey, it was a different route. You know, and that route wasn't all about career anymore. It wasn't all about money. It was all about me just seeking intellectually. And now on my part, that's a very hard thing to support, which I truly understand from a lot of people, because we have this misconception that we all have to be lawyers and doctors and do this and do that. And I think it's because of what we've been taught from when we were little, that we go accomplish this, we got to accomplish that. So I can see why I support all my friends' success, but mine is not supported. So, and that's why I kind of sort of keep to myself, because I think when you see everything, when you get away from the discriminative mindset, every individual, no matter what they do, whether they're a janitor, they live on the street, they all accomplish something. They all accomplish something. And that is that mentality that in most cases, wrong teaching has abrupt on us. So we are very quick to judge, and it's understandable. So for me, I remember when I was in my 20s, if you tell me I would be a billionaire by the time I reached my 50s, I would think you're actually smoking something. But for me, the word billion actually means different things to me. It is the abundance that I cannot even comprehend it. It is the ability to open up a certain stage of my brain. Because to a lot of us, whether we want to accept it or not, we are still on the control mode that we've been taught from when we were little. How life should go. How this should go. That's why we never, ever get out of that lane and try to question, what is this? So not having that ability to actually step out of the lane, it can be difficult, because it creates a lot of mindset. I can't even be around my family and friends without getting lectured to the bone. Oh. And I just think, and the more I do that, it just really cracked me up. One of my very, very, very great uncles, I hope he listened to this, he literally just stopped talking to me. And I just think sometimes it is that mentality of discrimination that my grandmother has went through, that I decided I would never, ever let anything persuade my thinking, and I'm always going to walk my own walk. And I know it's very difficult sometimes for people to actually understand it. And to a lot of my friends and families who think I've lost my mind, I truly understand. But I'm just saying, when you become a true Afrikaner, a true self, you embrace others and you begin to look at everyone's success, whether you realize it or not. Everybody is successful in a way. I love, love seeing all my friends, their nice cars, their nice houses. It just brings me this sort of joy of, wow, they did it. It is a great accomplishment, education. You know, like we all have those degrees, but it's just that it's very funny that we cannot do the opposite. So when we begin to learn how to do the opposite, things are actually different. And that is because many out of 100 people that say, I believe in God, I'm spiritual, out of 100, and I'm going to say 80 is more on their material energy than the spiritual energy. They can deny, but it's just that, it is just, we are just so afraid. And that is because of that energy that is on the material things more than we realize. So, another beautiful day. As I continue this 26 miler. And the key to this thing, to sustain the body, is a lot of yoga and push-ups. It is so amazing. Do your yoga, do your push-up. You could run all day for as long as you want. The only thing is, you might have to breathe a lot into your body, but trust me, just that. Calisthenics, yoga, and you're good to go. All you have to do, go back into your animal instinct. Don't be in a rush and do it very slowly. Because a lot of time when you look at the sky moving slowly, that is your body, that's how it moves. So yes, let me stop this thing real quick. I've got this incline coming up and I'm going to say happy, I guess it's Thursday today. Whew. Yeah, Akoda is heading to work. Happy Thursday. So, I got different jobs. I just happened to run there. That's all. Happy Thursday and one love.